Hari Om. Mental hygiene. Now, we all bathe our bodies every day. Very keen on that. But how many of us bathe the mind? Very few. Bathing the mind is a very, very important concept, and bathing it daily. It has to be cleansed, you know. Mind, come to think of it, the mind is more important than the gross body. We take so much of care of what we intake in the gross body. Like your food has to be very clean, the kitchen has to be clean, the utensils have to be clean. The person who cooks the food, we prefer that he should have a bath. His, you know, mental vibes also go into the food that he is cooking. So we always want somebody with a pure mind to be doing the cooking, like your mother or somebody who is a very pure lady doing the cooking, or anybody. So now the thing is, but who takes care of the mind? And the mind is the chairman come managing director of the body. Unless the mind allows, the body will not move. No matter what the mind says, the body will do. So how much of us take care of the nutrition of the mind? We just put in all kind of garbage into the mind, no matter what it is. Watching television, the assault of the media from all the senses, you know, any kind of murder story, rubbish, filth, lusty story, we just keep on looking at it. Political corruption, we keep looking at it, and it all forms the food of the mind. Because mind partakes of food from the eyes, from the ears, and from the nose. And these three, if you do not control, and if you do not control at will, they will put in all kinds of garbage into your mind. And that garbage will stay, it will rot, and then it will stink. And then you wonder from where the sorrow is coming. So the purity of the mind is very, very important. So every day you must make a special effort to consciously think of the mind and empty it completely of, you know, lust, greed, jealousy, hatred, some hurt that you may have felt, you know, somebody insulted you, somebody said something. Now all these things are garbage in the mind. And just like you empty out your garbage can every day, you don't keep it for weeks or months. You empty it out every day, sometimes morning and evening. So why not you empty out the mind completely of what happened yesterday? And your mind should be absolutely clean and fresh like a baby's, you know. It is this kind of mind that you can use for happiness. Otherwise, there is no happiness in the mind whatsoever. Vivekananda has used Patanjali's Ashta Yoga Shastra's one of the sutras, and he has called it Pratyahar, which is very, very important. Now, Pratyahar means that from all the five senses, what you intake, you should be able to control at will. I don't want to see this, I don't want to hear this, I don't want to speak this, I don't want to consume this, or whatever it is. So all this you should have a control. Not that any gossip, any filth, anything, somebody is tumbling it into your mind and you are standing there listening to it. Why? Because it all becomes a part of your mind. You are feeding your mind with it. And the mind has a nature of repeating itself. So all that will go on tumbling out of your mind, sometimes in sleep, sometimes in the waking stage. That same scene will go on coming in your mind again and again. So you have to be very careful. The purity of the food. Now if somebody serves you a beautifully dressed meal and another person comes and whispers in your ear that there's poison in this, will you take it? No, you will never touch it, no matter how beautiful it is, because it will sicken your body, right? So anything that sickens the mind, if you get to know that this thing will be lodged in my mind and this murder story is going to go on repeating itself in my mind, why do you want to hear it? Or why do you want to see it? How is it benefiting you in any way? It is not. So Pratyahar is the control of the senses at will, to take in only that which is beneficial for the mind, not just anything and everything. So much for the hygiene of the body. And when you keep the mind absolutely pure, it is only the pure and still mind, which is not turbulent with all kinds of lusts, greed, hatred, desires. That kind of a mind is a very, very peaceless mind, you know. So to have a peaceful mind is to have a happy mind. And when peace will only come with pure thoughts into a very clean mind, and you have to work consciously to make your mind very clean, very peaceful. So peaceful mind is a blissful mind, happy mind, it's a divine mind. Hari Om.